Today's home practice is a modification of a practice coming from this book, The Heart of Yoga by Desika Char. It's a modification of practice one. Begin by standing. Come into your own mountain pose. On the breath in, reach the arms out and up. On the breath out, return the arms to your side. Breathing in. Breathing out. Coordinate the movement to last through each part of the breath. We will do this a total of 8 times. If you would like to add another layer of challenge, on the breath in, the heels can rise. And on the breath out, the heels can lower. Two, back in mountain. Breathe in, arms up. Breathe out, we're going to fold. Let's actually slide the hands down the legs. Breath in, rise. Breath out. Like another layer of challenge, this modification, breath in, exhale, breath out. Last time. Arms return to your side. Mountain pose. Take the feet wider apart. Let the toes pointed forward. Let the arms hang at your side. We're going to twist back and forth as fast or slow as you'd like. Turn the head with you if you can. If not, look straight ahead. About 12 times, and then wrapping the hands around the height of the waist. About 12 times. And then tapping the breastbone and tapping behind your back about 12 times. Waist. Arms hanging. Slowing down. Mountain pose. Transitioning to all fours. Like a table. Toes curled under. Breath in. Lift the chest. Breath out. Raise the hips, straighten the legs. Breath in. Knees down. Chest reaches forward. Exhale. Lift the knees and the hips. 6 times in total. Thank you. arms up and back toward the floor behind you. Breathe out. Pick the 2 feet up and draw the thighs towards your chest. Breathe in. Lift your legs straight to the sky. Breath out. Bend the knees, thighs toward the chest. Keep the low back on the floor. Breathe in to the chest and rib cage. Lower the feet. Breathe out. Let the arms come to rest at your side. Remember, coordinate your movements with the pace of your breath. Don't make the breath longer or shorter to match the movement. Change the speed of the movement to match the length of the breath. Breathing in, shoulders back against the floor. Breathing out, thighs toward the chest. Breathe in, raise the legs. Breathe out, thighs toward the chest. Don't arch the back as you bring the feet down to the floor. Maybe it's 1 foot at a time. Breath out, arms rest at the floor on the other side. 4 more rounds, please. Let your arms come to rest on the floor, the soles of your feet touching the floor. Be still for a few breaths. Bring the 2 feet up off the floor, arms out wide in a T. Your hips from side to side a couple of times while you have your arms and hands pressing into the floor. And then keep the back of the shoulders against the floor, eyes near the chest. Exhale, drop the knees to one side. Keep the opposite shoulder down on the floor. Don't let it roll. 12 breaths here. If you want to have a stack of books or a yoga block there for your legs to rest on, you can. The farther the knees are from the chest, the easier it is. A little more challenging when the knees are closer, so you can adapt in a way that's good for you. You press the back.
into the floor. Roll your rib cage away from your knees, and that'll help you anchor that opposite shoulder against the floor. If it's comfortable for you, you can allow the head to turn away from the knees, and you can look toward that hand. It's a long, slow breath. And we're here for about 12 rounds of breathing. And then breath in. Head back to the center, knees closer to the chest. Exhale, drop the knees to the opposite side, round that other shoulder, push the head, press with the hand, maybe look away from the knees, and breathe. Keep reaching out through this top thigh and knee. About 12 breaths on this side as well. And let your feet come back to the floor, come back onto your back, and rest for a breath or two. Let everything be settled and heavy against the floor. And then turn to one side. Use your hands and arms to help yourself come up. We're going to kneel now. So if you like to have a blanket under your knees, you can. If you want to stand and have a chair or a table in front of you and do this sequence from standing, you can. Breathe in, arms reach up. Breathe out. Bring the forearms to the floor with the elbows bent. Breath in, lift the elbows into table. Breath out, push back into pose of the child. Breathe in, reach up. Breathe out, fold. Forearms on the floor. Breath in, elbows lift. Breath out, pose of the child. Breathe in, reach up. You can use your hands pressing against the floor to help you come up if you want. Breath out. Breath in. Breath out. Tuck the tail, roll back. And breathe in. Breathe out. Breath in, take your time, don't go quickly. Breath out. Rise on the inhale. Fold on the exhale. Breath in, open. Breath out, bow. Final sequence, breathing in. Into pose of the child.
Find a comfortable spot for you. You can stay in pose of the child for your final relaxation, or if you have more time, you can transition onto your back for a full Shavasana. use the remainder of your time to enjoy the peace and serenity that you have.